Convicted of drug trafficking crimes are now eligible to petition courts for early release. NPR's Carrie Johnson reports the change follows a unanimous vote by the U.S. Sentencing Commission.
Federal officials estimate more than 46,000 inmates could take advantage of the sentencing break. Prisoners can start petitioning judges for early release, and courts are already gearing up for the process. But no one will actually get out of prison until November 2015. Judge Patty Saras, who leads the U.S. Sentencing Commission, says the change will reduce costs and prison overcrowding without endangering public safety. Saras urges Congress to fix systemic problems with mandatory minimum sentences. Lawmakers have been considering reforms, but none of the proposals has received votes by the full Senate. Karen Johnson, NPR News, Washington.
U.S. shares are moving higher following news that the Bank of Japan will implement new economy stimulus measures. Nikkei rose 5%, and all the major U.S. market indices are up more than 1%. Dow up 179 at 17,474. This is NPR.
Support for NPR comes from Staples, with cleaning and break room solutions for small business owners. More at Staples stores or staples.com. Staples, make more happen.
Good afternoon, you're listening to the WMAN News at 8, followed by Matt Walsh, 104. Let's get an update on the roads now with Randy Cox.
Hey there, Matt. Well, real quiet today, not seeing anything major on the major roadways. We're good on the loops, 95 in Virginia and Maryland. A tad slow westbound 66 after an earlier accident near Nutley. And the usual congestion on 395 First Street Tunnel northbound before New York Avenue. I'm Randy Cox.
This traffic report is made possible with support from Hero Smoke Alarms.
Maryland State Police are asking anyone who sports some free cash after an owner truck's door flew open this morning in Interstate 270 to return it. A lock on the armored truck apparently malfunctioned, causing the door to open and a bag of cash to fall on the 270 Maravana, sending money flying into the air. They say a number of drivers stopped on the interstate to grab what cash they could before a fire department vehicle arrived and turned on its emergency lights. Responding troopers were able to help the truck's driver recover about $200. It's not known how much cash was lost. Police want anyone who took some of the flying cash to return it to the state police barrack in Frederick. Police charges for theft. Anyone taking Metro this weekend could face waits of up to 20 minutes for a train. Matt McCluskey has details.
No stations are slated to close this weekend for Metro's ongoing capital improvement project, but work will be happening, and the train station says passengers could again face longer than usual waits on the platform. Starting at 10 tonight, trains on 5 lines will run just once every 20 minutes all weekend on the blue, orange, silver, green, and yellow lines. Also on the yellow line, trains will only be going as far north as Mount Vernon Square. Anyone headed beyond that will have to switch to a green line train. On the red line, trains will be running end to end once every 15 minutes all weekend, but between 9 a.m. and 9 p.m. tomorrow and Sunday, extra trains will be running between Van Ness and Norma Gallaudet. That'll make the way through that stretch more like 8 to 10 minutes. Metro says service should be back to normal on Monday. I'm Matt McCluskey.
Mostly cloudy skies throughout the rest of the afternoon, mainly high near 60, then overnight cloudy with a low of 45. Scattered showers possible tomorrow night, but 32 on Sunday. And then 48 degrees, but it will be a killer. It's 106.